The former Maharashtra Home Minister highlighted how BJP leaders and agencies have threatened him to filing a fake affidavit. In the case of Sandesh Kale in West Bengal, the women have confirmed on video that BJP leaders forced them to file fake statements. Similarly, I'm told in my matter, Mr. Adani on October 16, 2023, got my friend to his office in Ahmedabad and threatened him with dire consequences to file a fake affidavit. Actually, it was Mr. Adani's in-law, Mr. Cyril Shroff, who filed the fake affidavit and forced him to sign it. Even today, every mid-level official in Adani's office calls mid-level officials in the CBI and says, 161 statement change karaiye, aapka sir ko bulaiye, madam ke against mein statement dijiye. I am telling the CBI, why are you, madam? Please take a 164 statement once and for all. Don't keep calling back people at Adani's behest to change 161 statements to implicate me. It's going to get you nowhere. Let us reduce the CBI and the ED budget to zero. Let us, Mr. Adani, pay the full 1500 crores. Let us outsource it completely to him. End of story.
It is Suomoto Privilege Committee has to take action on this. It was very serious allegation. A member of parliament is being tortured by a business house and still it is being doing. That has to be looked into by the Privilege Committee. The privilege of
Sabhapati Mahodaya, ye jis case ke bare mein jikr kar rahi hain, wo Lokpal par mera case hai. Mera case hai. मैंने कंप्लेन किया है, मेरे कंप्लेन पर वो केस है, वो मामला सब जुडिस है, उसको सीबीआई और ईडी इन्वेस्टिगेट कर रही है और इसीलिए इस सदन में नो क्या, ये मेरा केस है, लोकपाल पर मैंने जो है कंप्लेन किया हुआ है और ये केस मेरे ऊपर है, इसीलिए मैं यहाँ बैठा हुआ हूँ। ये कुछ भी हो रहा है तो दर्शन हीरानंद दानी को यदि हिम्मत है जिसके बारे में ये बात कर रही है, उसको हिंदुस्तान में आके सीबीआई उसको बुला रही है, वो आ क्यों नहीं रहा है?
The Manrega budget during COVID, when the center was telling all the states, please give employment to the laborers, they are going back. The Manrega budget in 2021 was 0.6% of GDP. Do you know what it is today? 0.26%. Theodore Roosevelt, the 26th president of the United States, had said, in any moment of decision, the best thing you can do is the right thing. The next best thing you can do is the wrong thing. And the worst thing you can do is nothing. The Honorable Finance Minister has made a mockery of the people of India in this Union Budget by doing absolutely nothing. Whatever little changes are there are regressive and ill thought out. You've not listened to the mandate. Vinash Kale Viparit Buddhi, you have done the exact opposite. You've kept the same cabinet, you've kept the same finance minister who's given the same shoddy budget. Who is this budget for? The middle class make up 31% of India. The poor make up between 60 and 65% of India. I will demonstrate how this budget systematically strangles the poor and the middle class. This is a kursi bajao budget, a save the chair budget for this government, and even that it doesn't do very well. Broadly, there are two types of taxes, direct taxes, indirect taxes. Direct taxes are known as progressive taxes. Why are they progressive? So income tax, property tax, investment tax on capital gains, these are done in a way that the richer you are, the more tax you pay. So they're kind of fairer. Sir, please. Sir. Indirect taxes are regressive because everyone from the richest billionaire to the poorest laborer is paying the exact same tax. So GST, duties on petrol, duties on diesel are all indirect taxes. When we strive for a fair and equitable economy, we must have the balance of direct taxes and indirect taxes right. The US and the Europe broadly collect about 60% through direct taxes and 40% through indirect taxes. In India, it is the exact opposite. 65% of tax collection comes from indirect taxes, where billionaires pay the same as the poorest laborers, and only 35% comes from direct taxes. For the first time in our country's history, salaried professionals and the middle class are sharing a greater tax burden than rich corporates. If you look at RBI's housing index for the past 10 years, the average rise in property prices has been between 4.5% and 5%. So if the middle class is invested in property, that is below 11% return, so indexation is going to harm you. The current GST regime is irrational and iniquitous. There is 18% GST levied on life insurance and medical insurance products. The Honorable MOS Finance yesterday on Monday told this house that the government has collected 8,263 crores as GST on health insurance for the fiscal year 23-24 alone. This is blood money. Our Honorable Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee wrote a letter to the Finance Minister to the centre pointing out that this is a completely anti-people tax. What is life insurance? What is health insurance? It is people guaranteeing and spending money and protecting against life's uncertainties, against accident, against injury, against ill health, against death. What are you doing? You are imposing GST, same rate that a billionaire pays, the poorest middle class person has to pay. So people are deterred from taking out new policies. People are deterred from continuing existing insurance. This should be removed at the earliest. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, minus 18%. Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, minus 9%. ICDS, which affects every child, it's a school scheme, minus 34%. Mission Anganwadi, minus 5%. PM Poshan, minus 45%. PMGSY, those of us who have rural areas, the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana scheme, minus 47% reduction in real terms. The National Social Assistance Program, minus 20%. The combined expenditure on five social schemes, the top five social schemes as a percentage of GST, of GDP, has declined from a peak of 0.93%, so almost 1% of GDP in 2009-10. Do you know where it is today in 23-24? It is 0.36%. Oh my. It is only a third of what it was in 9-10. The price of the cutlets in the parliamentary canteen in the last 10 years have been adjusted for inflation with the government's approval. The price of the cutlets in the parliamentary canteen have more than doubled. But when it comes to giving social security for the poorest of the poor, it is still 200 rupees in the last 10 years, no change. We have been unable to deter Pakistan. In the last 2 months alone, over 50 security personnel and about 10 civilian pilgrims have been killed in Jammu. Capital expenditure on military equipment, 1.7 lakh crores. On paper, this shows that it's almost a 10% increase. What we haven't taken into consideration is this increase was largely due to Russia's inability to supply contracted weapons to us because of the Ukraine war. If we take into account inflation and we take into account the dollar, rising dollar rate, we're almost flat. The gap between projections made by the armed forces and between actual allocation is 17 to 23%. That's the gap. Kursi bachane mein aap mast the. Desh ko bhi dekhiye. In short, this kursi bajao budget is a desperate attempt by the government to stick its head in the sand and act like that the mandate of 2024 never happened. But the coming days are going to prove the instability of this government and the inefficacy of its economic policy. We wait for that day. Thank you very much, madam. Thank you.